Hello, this is Betty, and this is a tutorial to show you how to create a page in Mahara. Now, I'm starting at the dashboard. I got here by going in through moodle.esc.edu and clicking on Mahara, and that's in the previous tutorial on Introduction to Mahara. From the dashboard, you can see that you have a number of choices. And each of the tutorial will go through each of these. I'm going to start with just portfolio to create a page. So if you click on portfolio, and if you have created pages before, they'll be listed here. Your dashboard page should be listed and your profile page, because those are automatically created for you. But let's go ahead and create a page. Note, next to this is copy a page, and you are welcome. If you click on that, you'll see a whole list of possible pages to copy. Many people create pages that they allow copying. So you may want to take a look at that and copy someone's page and play around with that. Some people like to learn that way. But we'll start with create a page. So if you click on create a page, it'll ask you for a title. And let's just say, let's create as my title. You can give a description, but you don't need to. I'm not going to do that. You can do tags, especially if you are creating a lot of pages. You may find that helpful. And I'll go ahead and save. You can change your display name if you want. I'll leave that. Once you save, you see your titles up here, and it automatically puts you into the editor. And really, in terms of creating a page, it is very much drag and drop. Now, there are a number of things that I do first in creating a page. One is the theme, because as you see, the theme here is unselected and it's very gray and not very interesting. My favorite is primary school, which gives a nice blue top to it. You see the blue there, and just seems to line it up nicely. On the left here, you see a number of choices, and in other tutorials, I'll go through some more of these. In this, I'm just going to show you text box and image. So, because text box is one of the most important things that you need in order to do a page. Before that, though, let me go up and edit layout, because that's also important. And you'll see there are many different options for layout, and that the default is three columns of equal size, which I don't really like. So I usually go with two columns of equal size, but as you see, there are many different choices. So if we go ahead and save that. And you can change that as you go through and work on your page. You don't have to stay with that. So the text box, what you would do is click on the text box and I don't know why I did that. There it goes. Okay. So it automatically opens a dialog box for you. This is the title. It's going to say text box if you don't do a title. So click in there. And let's call it first box. And here is where you would put your text. So as you see, it's got many of the capabilities of a regular word processor. So let's just say my name is Betty. Very interesting. I'm sure you can put in something far more than that. You can see how you can bold it. You can add smiley faces. You can add an image right within your text box. You can copy in some text. And so there's a whole range of things here. I'm just going to keep on going to show you what happens here. You can also add files, and it will show you any files that you've added under content. I'm going to skip over those and do save. And there's my text box. Now, if I want to edit my text box, I click on this little sprocket here. If I really don't like my text box, I can delete it immediately. And that is actually how you would add any of the components in here. So really, the main thing you want to do is play. Let's do an image, though. And we can just go over and you see how that kind of get the dashed area there, and then the box. And I'm just going to say here, well, let me go down and see what I'm going to choose. Now here I do have I can upload a file, an image, and I won't show you that because that'll take too long. But I'm just going to choose an image from down here, and you can see it ends up there. And then now that I've got my image selected, I can go down and save. And voila, there's the image. So it's very easy to do. And I could have added a title, another title there rather than that one. Once you're done, click done. Now, one thing to keep in mind, which will be in the next tutorial, is right now only you see that page. So there will be a separate tutorial which you should look at, which is sharing a page. But let's go ahead and log out.